channel Microbiology with Archana, and in today's video we are going to see estimation of proteins by Fallin-Lowry method. Okay students, let's see why we want to find out, or rather why we want to estimate the protein. See, proteins are present in many foodstuffs. It is present in natural sample, that is blood sample and all the things. So if you want to find out how much quantity of protein is there in the unknown sample or the sample which you want to find out, then you can use Fallin-Lowry method. Now, requirements. First is Fallin-Lowry reagents. Now, Fallin-Lowry reagent is prepared freshly. So, to prepare Fallin-Lowry reagent, we need two reagents, that is reagent 1 and reagent 2. Reagent 1, it has NaOH and sodium carbonate. Reagent 2 has copper sulfate and sodium potassium tartrate. So to prepare Fallin-Lowry reagent, we need 50 ml of reagent 1 and 1 ml of reagent 2. Then next, we need Fallin-CoSol2 reagent. This reagent is readily available. We just have to take equal volume of FCR reagent and water. Then we need sample protein. Sample protein means any sample from which you want to find out or estimate the protein. Then BSA stock. Now BSA is bovine serum albumin. So here we are going to take BSA as a standard protein, and here I am going to take a stock of 1000 micrograms per ml. Now let's see the principle of this method. Now here this is the structure of a peptide. So you all know peptide, it is made up of amino acids, and you also know that proteins are made up of amino acids. So an amino acid is linked to one another by a peptide bond. So here I have shown a dipeptide. So this is the peptide bond, that is CN bond. So this is present in your sample, and here this is when you are adding Fallin-Lowry reagent first, then what will happen? The copper in the Fallin-Lowry reagent, it will form, or rather it will chelate with the protein. So you can see the edge of the nitrogen is displaced, and copper complex, that is your protein copper complex, see, protein copper complex is formed. So this is the peptide nitrogen. So H is displaced. So you can see here H is displaced, and you can see this is a tetra. So four nitrogen. Okay, it is now copper is here in the center. So here what has happened? Chelation of the protein has taken place over here. So whatever complex is produced, it is called as protein copper complex. Also, it is called as biunit complex. Now, after this, we are going to add the FCR, that is Fallin-CoSol2 reagent. Now, after addition of FCR, it contains phosphomolybdenum tungstate. Now, FCR, it gets reduced. Okay, FCR, it gets reduced. After its reduction, what is produced? The reduced FCR, it has a blue color. So after addition of FCR and incubation for 30 minutes, what you will see? You will see a blue color solution. Okay, and that you have to take the absorbers. Now here there is a copper mediated oxidation of the amino acid. So your sample, this is your sample. So this is the protein copper complex. So now in your sample, proteins are there, and if the aromatic amino acid, that is tryptophan and tyrosine, when there is more amount of this aromatic amino acid, then you can see the intensity of the color which is produced is more dark. So the amino acids such as tyrosine and tryptophan, okay, there is a oxidation, and oxidation of amino acid and reduction of FCR, and this oxidation is mediated by the copper ions. So this is the basic principle of the falling Lowry test. Now we will see the dilution scheme. Now if you want to find out the concentration of unknown protein sample, then for that you will have to prepare the SDR. Now here we are going to prepare the SDR of BSA, that is bovine serum albumin. Now BSA is readily available, 1000 micrograms per ml we are going to prepare the stock. Now I will show you how to prepare the SDR. For preparing SDR we will have to do the dilution, that is from 100 to 1000 we will have to do dilution. We will need 10 test tubes and we will set a blank for this and sample also. So let's see. So second column is stock, third column is distilled water. So to prepare 100 micrograms per ml of the dilution, you will have to take 0.1 ml from the stock, add 0.9 ml of water. For 200, you will have to take 0.2 ml from the stock and add 0.8 ml of water. For 300, you will have to take 0.3 ml of stock and 0.7 ml from 0.7 ml of distilled water, and so on. So according to this table, you will prepare a dilution. Now the total volume, it will be 1 ml. But for doing this test, we don't need 1 ml, we will need 0.5 ml. So what I will do is, I will take 0.5 ml from the respective dilution. That is, from 100 micrograms per ml, I will take 0.5 ml. From 200, I will take 0.5 ml. So on, we will need 0.5 ml of the dilution. Now after taking the particular dilution, what we will do is, we will add 5 ml of our falling Lowry reagent. So 5 ml we have to add to each tube. At the same time, you have to take blank also. In blank, you have to take 0.5 ml of distilled water. And for sample, take the unknown sample, 0.5. After addition of 5 ml of falling Lowry reagent, you will have to mix it thoroughly and wait for 10 minutes. So let's wait for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you will have to add the FCR reagent, that is falling Iopalto reagent. 0.5 ml to each and every tube, to blank also and to the sample also. After that, mix it and wait for half an hour, that is for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you will have to take the absorbance. Now, absorbance is taken between 650 to 700 nanometer. So student, this was the protocol. Now let's do this practically. Okay students, let's do practically whatever I have explained you. So I will show you what we will need once again. So we need the stock of protein, that is BSA, bovine serum albumin, 1000 micrograms per ml. So this is 1000 microgram per ml of BSA. I have with me my falling Lowry reagent. I have with me my falling COSAL2 reagent and distilled water for doing the dilution. Now here I have 10 test tubes. So 100 micrograms per ml, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900 and 1000 micrograms per ml. So 10 tubes for dilution. This is for my blank and this is for my test sample. So let's do it. So I have adjusted my micropipette to 100 micrograms per ml. So let's do it. I am taking 100 microliters, that is 0.1 ml. So 0.1 ml in first. That is 0.2 ml. Point 3 ml. Then 0.4. Point 5. ml, 0.6 ml from the stock, then 0.7 ml from the stock, then 0.8 ml, then 0.9 ml, and in the last tube 1000 microliter, or we can say 1 ml. So I have added the BSA from the stock. I will change the tip and now I will add the distilled water. Okay. Okay, so in my first tube I have added 0.1 ml of my stock, so there I have to add 900 microliters or 0.9 ml. To the second tube 0.8 ml, to my third tube 0.7 ml of distilled water, then to my fourth tube 0.6 ml of distilled water, then to my fifth tube I am adding 0.5 ml of distilled water, then to the sixth tube I am adding 0.4 ml of distilled water, then to the seventh tube I am adding 0.3 ml of distilled water, to the eighth tube I am adding 0.2 ml of distilled water, and to the ninth I am adding 100 microliters or 0.1 ml of distilled water. To the last tube I am not going to add anything. Okay students, so now what I have done, see, total when we were preparing dilution scheme, that time the total volume of the 10 tubes it was 11 ml. So what I did, we need 0.5 ml. So what I did, I removed 0.5 ml from each and every tube. Now I have with me in each tube there is 0.5 ml of the sample, the dilution. Now to each and every tube I will have to add the Fallin Lowry reagent 5 ml. So let's do the addition. 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3 4 5. In this way, in all the tubes we have to add 5 ml of the Fallin Lowry reagent. Now I have taken 0.5 ml of distilled water for blank, and I am adding 5 ml of my Fallin Lowry reagent. Now this is my sample. I have taken 0.5 ml of the sample and to it I am adding 5 ml of my Fallin Lowry reagent. Now the additions of the reagent is over. Now we have 10 minutes of incubation time. So 10 minutes we will have to wait, and after 10 minutes I will add Fallin FCR reagent. So 10 minute incubation time is over now. So now next step is to add the FCR reagent. Now here I have the reagent following COSAL2 reagent. You have to add 0.5 ml to each and every tube, to the blank also, to the sample also. So let's start. Second tube to the third, fourth, sixth, seventh tube, eighth, ninth, tenth. Now I will add to my blank 0.5 ml and to the sample also 0.5 ml. So now all my additions is over. Now what we have to do is we have to incubate it for 30 minutes at room temperature, and after 30 minutes we will take the absorbance. Okay students, now half an hour of incubation time is over, and in front of you we have 10 test tubes of our dilution. We have blank, we have sample also. Now what we will do is we will take the audio of the tubes. Okay, now let's take the OD. Now I have taken, I have adjusted the colorimeter to 680 nanometer. I will show you first reading. So I have kept here blank in the slot. I have adjusted zero. Now I'll remove that and I will take first reading. The first reading is 0.09. I'll remove it. Now we will take second. Again I will adjust with the blank 0. I'll keep the second one. You can see the reading 0.32, and in this way I will take reading of each and every tube and reading of my test sample. So now you can see in front of you, these are the reading of my 10 tubes and sample. Now by using the following reading I will plot the graph. Here I have plotted the graph, so you can see on x-axis I have plotted concentration, and that concentration is in micrograms per ml. So I have taken the concentration of 100, 200, 300, 400 till 1000 micrograms per ml. So on x-axis there is a protein concentration. On y-axis absorbance is there, and I have taken the absorbance at 680 nanometer. I will show you scale. So this is scale. So on x-axis my 1 centimeter is equal to 100 micrograms per ml. On my y-axis 2 centimeter is equal to 0.1 OD. So you can see here I have taken 2 centimeter is equal to 0.1 OD. Now I have plotted the graph by using the scale. Now I will show you how to plot the unknown. So my the OD of the unknown is 0.48. So I will show you how to plot here. So 0.48. So 0.4 is here. 0.45 is here. So 48, so 41, 45, 46 is 45,
then 46, 47, 48. So here. So you can see here, 0.4 is here. This is 0.45 and here it is 0.48. So here it is touching the scale line. And now what I'll do is I will extrapolate it on my x-axis. So you can see here I have extrapolated it. So here you can see the extrapolation. So you can see here on x-axis, here it is intersecting on 450. It is my 480. So sample is having 480 micrograms per ml. So the sample is having the concentration of 480 micrograms per ml. Now I will tell you how to find out the concentration, because here I have done the dilution of the sample and I will show you how to find out the concentration. Okay student, just now I told you or showed you how to draw the SDR, and from that SDR we found out the unknown protein sample concentration. So the unknown protein protein concentration is 480 micrograms per ml, but the protein sample which I took, I diluted it, so the dilution factor is 10, and the volume which we took for doing the practical, it was 0.5. So that's why I divided it by 0.5. So 480 into 10, it is 4800 divided by 0.5, and the answer is 9600, that is 9600. So the sample which I took for analysis, it contains 9600 micrograms of protein per ml. Okay, so this is how we have performed the practical. If you like my video, please share it, subscribe my channel and like it. Thank you.